Hey guys, I'm gonna edit a video about liquid vanadium tetrachloride, and I thought that before that, it would be nice to make a video about the preparation and some properties of vanadium trichloride. First, we need to synthesize disulfur dichloride. In the left test tube with a gas outlet tube, I condensed dry liquid chlorine. In the center flask, I put sulfur that I'm gonna melt. So I turn on the heating mantle, the sulfur begins to melt, and you can see how the inside of the flask is filled with sulfur vapor. Now I allow the chlorine to begin boiling and enter the flask with sulfur vapor. The point is that the chlorine, which gradually evaporates from the test tube, will enter this flask with molten sulfur, react with the sulfur vapor, forming disulfur dichloride, which will then condense in the straight condenser and drop into the receiving flask. Chlorine reacts very easily and quickly with sulfur vapor, and we can observe a fairly rapid formation of dark red drops. This is disulfur dichloride with an admixture of sulfur dichloride. The disulfur dichloride we need is an oily liquid of a yellowish-orange color, which is formed after distillation of a red liquid we initially obtained under normal conditions. Sulfur dichloride easily decomposes into disulfur dichloride and chlorine when the temperature increases. For comparison, I show you two samples, the disulfur dichloride we just obtained with an admixture of sulfur dichloride, and to the right of it, the freshly distilled disulfur dichloride. This is what fresh, pure disulfur dichloride looks like without any impurities. If we start bubbling chlorine into it again, it will turn dark red due to the formation of sulfur dichloride. Disulfur dichloride is capable of burning, but it does this only in an atmosphere of pure oxygen. To clearly show the combustion of this substance, I used liquid oxygen. Here you can see that combustion occurs only at the point of contact between liquid oxygen and disulfur dichloride. At room temperature, disulfur dichloride is hydrolyzed by water to sulfur dioxide, hydrogen chloride, and elemental sulfur, causing the solution to become cloudy. It reacts with hot concentrated nitric acid to form sulfuric acid, nitrogen dioxide, hydrogen chloride, and water. When heated, disulfur dichloride easily dissolves red phosphorus. But this is what will happen if I put burning magnesium into this liquid. I've already carried out this reaction with many other liquid inorganic chlorides, and this reaction will also go into the collection. Now let's proceed to the synthesis of vanadium trichloride. To do this, I'll take an ordinary one-neck flask and place vanadium pentoxide in it, which I'll boil with an excess of disulfur dichloride for 8 hours. After completion of the reaction, we will obtain a dark purple mass consisting of anidium trichloride, disulfur dichloride, and elemental sulfur. Next, you need to drain off unreacted disulfur dichloride and wash the precipitate with carbon disulfide. Note that carbon disulfide is properly stored under a layer of water, which is why you see two layers of liquid here. So I wash the precipitate with carbon disulfide and distill it and the remaining disulfur dichloride in a vacuum. Thus, I received pure, dry vanadium trichloride. If we heat this powder in a stream of hydrogen, then as a result of this reaction we will obtain, as stated in Wikipedia, apple-green vanadium dichloride. Also, as a result of a competing reaction, vanadium trichloride will be reduced to metallic vanadium, leaving a vanadium mirror on the walls of a quartz tube. If we look at the reaction products, we'll see the same apple-green vanadium dichloride among metallic vanadium and unreacted vanadium trichloride. Vanadium was so named because it forms compounds with beautiful colors. But these colors differ not only depending on the oxidation state of vanadium. Also, when we add vanadium trichloride to different organic solvents, we also will get different colors. For example, I took 6 different solvents: pyridine, acetone, methanol, ethanol, tetrahydrofuran, and all alcohol. With each of the solvents, vanadium trichloride forms an adduct of a certain color. In general, in chemistry, it's vanadium compounds that have the widest range of colors. As with all other vanadium compounds, anhydrous hydrazine reacts very violently with vanadium trichloride. Now that you're already familiar with vanadium trichloride, you will be much more interested in watching my next video about vanadium tetrachloride, which is a liquid. Be sure to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss it, and also don't forget to like and, if possible, become my patrons, as some of my viewers have already done, and whom I love very much. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video!